where would you likely be finding Generation Z at the weekend? Well, to answer that, I'm talking to Jonathan Armstrong from AMP Capital Shopping Centres, as you've just conducted a large Kiwi survey to find out. Good morning, Jonathan.
Hi, Holly. How are you?
I'm really good. So tell us, where are these Generation Zs hanging out?
That's an interesting question, isn't it?
Yeah.
So AMP have just completed their 11th annual recommended retail practice report, and basically what it's told us is that these Generation Z, which are 18 to 22-year-olds, are socialising and shopping in our shopping centres.
Right, okay, so you'd think these trendy young'uns are actually online and only online shopping.
Well, they're bucking the trend, actually. So they're certainly using the internet, but they are spending a lot of time with a social experience of going to shopping centres.
So is that the key there? What is it that they're not really liking about the shopping experience online?
Well, they're going hand in hand to a certain degree. So what they're doing is they're doing a lot of pre-research, pre-shopping online. So they're spending time creating a wish list, if you like, and they're researching the products and the places that they want to go to. But the experience is the key, and what we've found in this research is that actually what they're looking for is the social activity of shopping. So some of them have been disappointed with shopping online, so they've ended up with things that don't fit them, they're the wrong colour, all of that sort of thing. So this generation, which is fantastic, are now saying we want to go back to bricks and mortar, the social experience.
I'm really pleased about that, because I actually love going to a shopping centre, and you know, I don't want them going anywhere, I don't want to just have a virtual world. So what are you doing, I guess, within your shopping centres that really is engaging that generation?
Oh, sure, heaps of things. I mean, AMP Capital are somewhat leaders in this domain. We have a department called placemaking, and we spend a lot of time and money and research working out what it is that will bring these people to the centres. We're making sure, like good retailers, that we're interacting online with them as well. So we use a trend series, a fashion trend series, which we do online at Botany Town Centre in Auckland, for example.
Yeah.
When they get to the centre, we have selfie stations. So when they actually have made a purchase and they're there with friends, it's a social experience for them. They take their photo of themselves and they post it online. So it's growing that experience.
Yeah.
And we're doing that right across all of our centres.
And you've also, as part of that research, found that there were other factors with that age group that were really important to them when they were shopping for something the brands that they chose. What was that?
Well, and the statistic, I think, is 61% of Generation Z shoppers, as opposed to 49% of all other shoppers, are actually saying that they want their shopping experience and their purchasing to mean something to them. So they're interested in environmental issues, sustainable issues, accessibility issues. I mean, we've got two shopping centres, Bayfair and Tauranga in the Palms and Christchurch, that were rated platinum accessibility recently. It's exciting. It's taking what people take for granted and turning it into something that's really important about the experience. We have community gardens. We run community days. There's just so many things that you have to do these days, and AMP make a great job of it in our shopping centres about socialising and making it part of an experience.
Yeah, so it's not just a shopping centre, it's actually
it's
a community hub.
No, it's
and,
not. Right.
And somewhere to hang out if you're a young'un.
That's right, exactly.
Just like us, yeah? Fantastic, some very interesting findings. Good to know our teens still want to come out into the world, not just stay in their rooms, as they are our future shoppers. Thanks so much, Jonathan.
Thank you, pleasure.